Welcome to the Treehouse of Love. We're live. Join the conversation at 512-836-0590. Now, here are Todd and Don.
We always begin the 7 o'clock hour with the top stories you need to know about. We begin with a spokesperson out of Allen, Texas. He says a record has been found of a telephone call to police. That attorneys for the shooter in El Paso, his mom, made that phone call. Sergeant John Felty says the call was taken on June the 27th from a woman who did not identify herself or her son and says at no time did she express any concern about him being violent. She just wanted more information about, is he old enough to even own this gun?
Right.
Also in the daily top stories you need to know about here, the Texas Democrat Party is now suing State House Speaker Dennis Bonnet and conservative activist Michael Quinn Sullivan, seeking to release a recording made secretly of a meeting between the two. Yeah, this lawsuit filed in state district court here in Austin yesterday alleges the meeting violated state campaign finance laws. Sullivan has said he recorded his June meeting with Bonin. Also, the transformation of the old University Medical Center Brackenridge will continue this month as work begins on the construction of the 17-story office tower. A portion of the Brackenridge campus will be torn down to make way for this new tower. University of Texas says it will provide more space for medical research. And here's some good news. The Texas economy continues to defy expectations that it would be, well, slowing down in the first half of the year. Dallas Federal Reserve economist Leila Assani says the economy continues to soar right here in Texas.
Texas job growth in the first half of the year outpaced the nation and its own long-term trend rate.
She says the trend will continue despite some weakening growth within the oil and gas sector. Austin has seen the second strongest job growth rate of the year behind Dallas. Zebra mussels continue to have a negative impact on the area, various waterways, and scientists say the invasive species may be partly to blame for that toxic blue algae in Lady Bird Lake that has now killed three dogs. John Higley is with the Austin-based group EQO. Tell CBS Austin the mussels eat all kinds of algae, but they do not eat that toxic blue algae, which has allowed it to flourish.
So it creates a perfect breeding ground for them to have these big blooms. When they bloom like this, that's when the toxins become problematic.
Yes, a preliminary report on this algae bloom will be released later today. More than 40% of the water surface in that Redbud Isle area is covered by this blue algae. So now you're up to date on the top stories you need to know about before you get in the work truck, before you get to that cubicle. And we've got links to all of these stories on the front page at newsradioklbj.com.
I don't want to, you know, I'm not asking for a flood, but we need some good heavy rain to kind of get the water moving down there and get to kind of scour the place out.
Yeah.
Nature to do its thing there.
Yeah.
And things are a little bit too still right now, a little bit too warm. That's my very, very scientific opinion.
Well, listen,
on
you
this,
did, you,
based on the research on blue algae that I have done over the years extensively.
Who was your 10th grade science teacher at Westlake High? Do you remember
his name?
It all came back to you there for a second, man. You got all scientific. You were like Bill Nye the Science Guy for a second.
I think that was Howard Warner. He taught biology. He didn't teach. He hired, and it wasn't Howard. It was hired.
Yeah.
He didn't teach biology.
No.
He taught biology.
Of course. No.
People,
exactly.
And he kind of people. You got your monocotyledon, your dicotyledon, your paramecium. That was Howard Warner.
Mm-hmm.
Biology.
There you go. One of the best, right?
One of the best.
Is he one that started the fire with the Bunsen burner?
No.
Is he the guy?
No. That was me.
No, that was you.
Yeah, and I think he's a listener, by the way.
Listen,
so, morning, Howard.
Listen, the Department of Transportation disallows a Delta ban on pit bulls. If you have a pit bull and it's your official service animal, the U.S. Department of Transportation says you can board a plane with that pup. Yeah, the DOT issued a statement stating that the airlines cannot ban specific breeds of dogs from being brought on board as service animals. Yeah, the ruling stems from an issue Delta Airlines raised when it prohibited pit bull service animals last year.
Mm-hmm.
And the DOT says, nah, you can't do that.
Yeah.
Well, what this will probably do is lead to Delta Airlines banning all animals.
Yeah, exactly. I don't have a problem with service animals as long as they don't cause me a problem. If they don't get in my way, if I don't have to step in their poop like I did at Waterloo Records that time.
Yes.
If I don't trip over them. If they don't smell, if they're not going to slobber on me, that's fine.
But I never know if it's a real service
animal.
That's
the thing. That's the thing.
I mean, there's been so many new ones. You see it all the time, and you're like, really?
Yeah.
That's a service poodle? What? Come on.
Where
you can tell when they're real and legitimate. You can tell.
Kim and I were walking through a grocery store recently. I don't know where it was. But anyway, this guy's walking his big dog through, and I'm looking at him and the dog, and I'm like, he looks fine.
These service dogs are able to help with a variety of things.
I know.
You may not look at that guy and think and know that he has seizures and
they
various
can predict
things.
That.
Yeah, the things like that.
It's amazing.
They have unseen injuries, if you will.
But you have to wonder sometimes. You do have to wonder. And maybe most of what we're seeing are legitimate, but you do wonder, especially in Austin, where it's become such a dog-friendly town, I think, in some cases, to a fault.
I think Delta Airlines should be allowed to breed discriminate. I think they should be able to.
You do?
We have a lot of apartment communities that do it.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, they need to, given the fact it's a very small space.
Do you agree?
They
should be able to ban pit bulls, but not others. If they want to ban a certain breed, is that okay?
Who wants to get on a plane with a pit bull?
I'm
Show of hands.
Maybe you're, Michael Vick, maybe?
The Todd and Don Show.